Hey there, this is Manny from the GitKraken team, and today we're going to be going over forked repositories and how to keep them up to date inside of GitKraken. So, first things first, what is a forked repository? Well, fork is simply a copy of a repository. Forking a repository allows you to make changes to a project without directly changing the original project. Forks are a great way to propose changes to a project, especially if that project is being worked on by multiple people. Now, if you're collaborating on a project that is consistently being updated, it can be a bit tricky to keep your fork up to date with the original project. So in this video, we will demonstrate a workflow to set up your fork and manage it through GitKraken. So the first thing we're going to do is navigate to a repository on github.com. You can use, of course, the remote service of your choosing. And we're going to be collaborating on this forked repo example on GitKraken QA. Since we don't want to directly change this original project, we're going to create a fork for us to make our changes on. And we can do this by selecting this fork icon in the upper right-hand corner. Okay, so we're going to add it to our account. And in just a second, yep, we're going to create the fork. And so basically we will have a copy of this repository, and we can see that it is a fork of the original project, or a copy, up here. So we can see that the project owned by us, forked repo example, is forked from this project here. So let's hop in back into GitKraken here, and we're going to clone this repository. So in this video, I'm going to already assume that you have connected GitKraken to GitHub using OAuth. Alrighty, so I'm just going to browse here. We'll put it on our desktop. We'll slap it in this folder here. And we're going to want our forked repo example. Awesome. Okay, so now that we've have a fork cloned into GitKraken, the first thing we want to do is add the original project as a remote repository. And what this will do is allow us to see if any changes have occurred on the original repository while we make changes to our fork. So over here in the left column, we're going to click this green plus icon. And since we are integrated with GitHub, or we're using GitKraken's integration with GitHub, we can not only see the original project, but if there were additional forks of this repository, we'd also be able to see those projects as well. And for the name here, I'm just going to leave it as GitKraken QA. Sometimes you might see this name be called upstream, or it's the upstream repository. GitKraken will just default though to the owner's name on the service you're using. So in this case, the owner of this repository is named GitKraken QA. So we're going to just keep it at that name, and we will go ahead and add it. And we can see that it was added here in the left-hand corner. And we can also see, that there are icons to also help us indicate which branch belongs to which remote. So we can see that both our fork is up to date with the parent project on GitKraken QA. So we can hover over and see origin, and of course we can see GitKraken QA. So everything is looking good here. All right, so finally, one of the last things we'll want to do before we get started here is to check out all of the remote branches we'll want to be working on. By checking out a remote branch in GitKraken, we'll be creating a local copy that already has its upstream set to the appropriate remote. So since we don't want to directly interact with the original project, we'll want to check out the remote branches from our fork so that when we push and pull, we'll be doing so from the fork and not the original project. So we can see that master already has a local copy. I just want this develop branch here. And it looks like we have everything configured. So let's run through one of the more common workflows when using a fork. So we'll start by branching off the main working branch and making some changes here. So it looks like we'll be making changes to the develop branch, but maybe I want to have a feature here, and we're going to add to our to-do list. Awesome. keep in mind that your workflow might be different from what I'm doing here in this video, or whether it's your preference, company policy. So feel free to adjust these steps as you see best fit. So on our new local branch, I'm going to make some changes and make a commit, and going to do that by just quickly opening this README file. We'll give this some feature. Alrighty, so we're just going to save that, and if we hop into GK right here, there we go. We can see our whip node. Changes look good to me. Adding, and we'll commit that change there. Awesome. So if I push these changes, we're going to see that GitKraken is prompting us for what remote and what branch we want to be pushing and pulling from. So while, you know, you may be tempted to push directly to the original project, no, we're just going to keep it to this forked repo as we interact with it. And if I hit submit, we should see a successful push. We can already see in the remotes area that our branch has successfully made it there. Now, while it's not on the original project, we will be able to still merge these changes in with the original project. All right, so as you can see here, I've added a few more changes, and I'm pretty happy with how this turned out. My feature branch is starting to look pretty good, but you may notice in the graph that while we were working on our feature, things have been added to the original project. So we can see that there was a commit made to develop, our master branch has even had a commit made to it. So we're going to probably want to get those changes incorporated into our fork. That way our local copy, and as well as, you know, the fork itself on GitHub, will be up to date with the original project. So the first thing we're going to want to do is get on, go ahead and check out our develop branch here. And the good news is that our local branch for develop hasn't really changed all that much. So we can actually just do a fast forward merge here. So we can bump our develop, our local develop branch here, and we can see that develop is one commit ahead from our remote, which looks about right. So we can just go ahead and push those changes up to our remote, and we can see that, awesome, our fork has been updated and it's up to date with what is on the original project. And we can do the same thing here for master. So if I go ahead and check out master, and just do a fast forward. Another thing you can do is if maybe you have some changes, but you don't necessarily, you know, you're not super tied to them, or maybe you made some changes and they broke, you can always just do a reset. So we can always just say, let's reset master to this commit, and you can always keep your changes. But most cases, maybe you'll just want to do a hard reset and bump up that local branch up there. And we can see that once again, our branch is a commit behind. So we'll just push those changes. All right. And everything is caught up to date. So let's check out our feature branch here. And we can see that in the left panel, we've checked out our feature branch, and we're going to get back into getting this merged into our original project. So before I do open a pull request with the original project to get this feature branch into the develop branch, I'm going to go ahead and just rebase my changes that I've made on feature onto the branch that I plan on merging with. So I'm going to want to rebase those changes. We're probably going to see a conflict. Yup, we got ourselves a conflict. Alrighty. Looks like they were able to resolve. We'll just continue our rebase. Perfect. So we can see that our local branch is now on top of develop. We do have a reference to our old feature branch down here. Nothing that a good old force push can't do. Now, once again, I do reiterate that, you know, company policy is different. Maybe you do merging instead of rebasing, or it's your own personal preference. Please, 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 you know, tune this video to how you guys would do this. I'm just trying to give you an idea of a general workflow of working with a forked repository. You can do merging instead of rebasing. It's all personal preference at this point. The next thing I want to show, though, is that we can get these changes in. And the way we're going to do that is we're going to drag this branch here, and we're going to start a pull request to GitKraken QA from our origin. We're pretty happy. So we like, yep, that looks correct. Yes, this is the branch we're working on. This is the branch we want to merge into. Merge to do feature. And, you know, of course, you'll probably have a bit more of a creative title. And we can even select this link here to see our pull request on GitHub. Now, usually this would probably go through a whole review process. You know, maybe someone else would review it. Just for the sake of this video, though, everything seems to be good. We've already handled the merge conflict, so I'm just going to go ahead and merge this pull request in and confirm that merge. Awesome. So pull request was successful, and we can go back over here to GitKraken. And if I do a fetch, we should see those changes applied. Yep, very nice. So we can see that the original project develop has, their develop branch has been caught up, and using what we learned earlier in this video, we'll be able to check out our forked copy of develop, and we can just do a fast forward there. Or we could either do a reset. In either case, we're pretty happy with that. We can see that, okay, we're 5 commits behind here in the left panel, which looks about correct. And we'll just go ahead and push those up. And once that's done, very nice. So we were able to not only work on our project, our forked repository, but at the same time, we were able to keep the fork up to date whilst working on our stuff simultaneously. Awesome. Have a great day, guys.